guys, it's Hathaway. I'm back again, and this is going to be a swatching video. I thought I would try for this one to kind of talk about the polishers rather than writing a thingy at the end about the polishers. So let me know what you think. I'll probably do it for the ones that I film right now. Not filming with my microphone, so hopefully the sound's okay. I'm going to get into this, and I hope you enjoy. So first up, we have from Lynn B Designs. I got this one from Omnia. She sent me a big box of polishers. This one is ridiculous, so I'm assuming it was a Harry Potter collection. It's this really gorgeous, kind of like a egg blue, with a reddish kind of flash that you can see. It has shards in it that are, I think they're copper shards that shift to gold and almost to blue, various different sizes, kind of like a speckledy polish. My nails are quite short. I had an accident with one of my nails, and short nails is what you get as a result. I could have just fixed the nail I broke, however, this Quarren Queen decided not to. So the brush is a quite decent sized brush. It's not bad at all. It's a little on the thickish, like the polish. Has kind of like a thick creamy feel to it. Goes on quite nicely on the first coat. I can still see, from my angle, I can still see bare patches. What nail people are talking about is that you get spots like right here on this nail. There is a slightly darker spot, which is actually the natural nail showing through. It's like almost like a shadow. And that tells us that the coat is not completely even across the whole nail. It's not runny or anything, doesn't pull on the sides of the nail. The brush does pick up a little bit more than my short dinky nails like, but that's fine. So I'm just going to let this dry enough to put on the next coat, and I'll be back. Alright, back for the second coat. You can see that this actually dries slightly matte, like a demi-matte type of finish. So this builds up really nicely in two coats. If you want your nail to be shiny, you are going to need to put a shiny top coat on. I don't ever show polishers with, like my swatch pictures, are never with top coat, unless there is something special that happens when you put top coat on. I have a couple of polishers that when you put top coat on, they actually change slightly. But other than that, I always show them exactly how they dry. Sometimes I take my photos a little too quickly and they're not completely dry. But I prefer to show the finish of the polish as it is naturally. That doesn't stop you from putting top coat on, and I usually wear polishes with top coat if I want them to stay on, but for the purposes of swatching, I would rather you not be surprised if a polish dries matte and you think that it's shiny. So there's that. So this is a pretty nice polish. So this is Ridiculous from Lynn B Designs, and I will insert a swatch photo. So this polish here is from BYS, which is a brand we have here in Australia. This polish is called Blue. Yes, I am aware of the fact that it is in fact not blue. I do not know why it is called Blue. I thought this might be one of the thermal ones that I had that shifted green to blue, but there's no indication on here that it is one. Normally they have a little sticker up here that's in two colours. It doesn't mean that it's not, and as you can see, it really is called Blue. This is clearly not a blue polish. This is also quite an old polish. I have a lot of BYS in my collection because they don't cost very much. They cost more now than they used to, but they used to be about $2 a bottle. They're at $4, $5 now, but they were cheap, so, and pretty good nail polish, so I bought a lot of them. It has, you know, a standard brush. This one's not cut very straight. This actually looks really thin in the bottle, like the formula looks quite thin in the bottle. Considering how old this polish is, that's actually kind of surprising. Most polishes thicken up over time. This one apparently not. So it is a little thin, a little translucent on that first coat. Not really that surprised. A little bit streaky looking, which is normal for a polish that is a little bit on the thin side. It's not pooling or anything terrible like that, but it's not applying particularly smoothly. This one also doesn't smell really terrible. Way too much polish. Some BYS polishes, as they get older, smell really bad. I'll be back in a minute. So, as you can see, this polish dries matte. Now, that tells me that there's probably neon pigment in this, which might be why the colour changed. Sometimes that's a thing that happens. It could also be that it was a thermal, that the sticker's fallen off. Thermal polishes, after a period of time, at least old thermal polishes, I don't know about new ones, but like whether they've improved the thermal thing, but old thermal polishes, after a time, they shift to the second colour state. So like if the bottle originally looks blue and they shift to green, then they will shift to the green state and stay there. I don't know whether it still happens with the newer versions of thermal polishes, because thermals are really popular at the moment. So I hope they've improved the formula, because sometimes, you know, you spend a lot of money on a polish and it just does not look good. Now, I could do a third coat on these to improve them, but I'm not going to, because I don't like this polish enough to do that. And I also want you to see that it doesn't apply smoothly. It actually applies kind of patchy. And I can see all of these like dark spots on my nail where it hasn't covered evenly, except for on the little nail, which actually has thicker coat on it. The pointer is not too bad, but the two middle fingers actually look kind of lumpy, which is really weird. But that is because it doesn't go on particularly smoothly over itself, which is a bit of a bummer, basically. But anyway, it's still not going to get thrown out. The only time I throw out a polish is if it smells like death or it's dried up, because that's me. And I know a lot of people like to declutter. I'm not one of them. These videos are also going to be way longer, so if you want me to not talk, you'll get a faster video. I will insert the swatch picture. And next up we have this beautiful teal coloured polish. This is called Teal We Meet Again. It's from Angel Kiss Nail Lacquer. This was an Australian indie brand. They no longer exist. The lady who ran it decided she didn't have enough time to give it what it needed, so... But I don't know if you guys know, but a lot of the really good indie brands that are around at the moment are actually Australian, like Glam Polish. So this goes on quite nicely. First coat, brush is standard brush. I quite like the bottle shape for these. This was like, she actually changed her bottle shape for later releases, but I've got like a couple of collections that are this bottle shape, and I quite like it. They stack on like sideways quite nicely. It looks kind of good. You just can't see the brand logo, but that's not actually a problem because the brand logo on the front pretty much covers the whole of the polish. So it looks so good so far, so we'll see what it looks like on the second coat. So here we go with the second coat. I realised that my coat on my pointer finger, ring finger, is not as even as the others. So this is one of those polishes where you could do three coats or you could finesse your second coat. I tend to prefer to try and finesse this second coat. If your nails are super long or you have a really obvious free edge, like white tip on your nail, you're probably going to need the third coat. There is a lot of shimmer going on, which can trick the eye quite nicely. I'm judging these nail polishes based from my angle as I'm painting my nails. So I'm kind of looking at them from down in this direction, which is different from what you guys are seeing. So you might see things that I don't see, and I probably won't see them until I edit the photos. Unlike some nail swatches, I don't do a separate lot of painting my nails to do swatch videos. I literally take a photo of these nails that I just painted. It's a lovely polish. I love the colour. I enjoy it. I'm glad I have it in my collection. Now we'll insert a swatch picture. So, next up we have another BYS polish. This one, I bought it on sale, clearly, judging by the sticker. This is apparently a chrome polish. It is cold. Thank God it's Friday. It's actually not Friday, it's Monday when I'm filming this, but the polish is called, thank God it's Friday. It's purple. Another one of those. Saw it, had to have it because it was purple. I have far too many purple nail polishes. I hope I've shaken this up properly. There's a little bit of a line, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's not shaken up. Some polishes just separate. This has got quite a narrow brush. One of the risks with a chrome polish is that it's going to be like streaky, or that you'll get those weird lines down the nail. This is not doing too badly at the moment. This is not chrome like, you know, those chrome powders. This is more like the nail paints from Sally Hansen, just not as good. Those old nail paints, like the ones from the late 90s, early 20s, are the best ever. Not bad on one coat. Some people would walk out the door like that, but not me, because I'm going to do a second coat. One good thing about chrome polishes is that they generally dry really fast. However, they also chip really badly, and they often do not respond well to top coat. It can completely change the colour, it can remove the chrome, so that is something to take into account. They're really a one night kind of polish. Like, you put them on for a special occasion and you don't expect it to last past midnight. But it does cover completely in two coats, and it's a beautiful colour. I will insert a swatch picture. Okay, next we have another BYS polish, another one I bought on sale. This is actually the first of two red polishes. This one is apparently a scented polish. It's supposed to smell like cherries. BYS did a whole bunch of these. It looks like it's got little white glitters in it. I don't remember it having glitter in it. Anyway, I did not purposely pick two red polishes. I have all of my nail polishes that have been swatched on swatch sticks in a spreadsheet kind of program. It's called Airtable. It exists in the cloud, which means I can't lose it, which is great. And it's also free. Anybody can use it. So I have them all in there, and they're all numbered. And then I use a number generator. And I mark them off on the spreadsheet when they have been swatched in a video like this, to try to avoid doubling up. Sometimes I forget to mark them off and end up doing that anyway. But yeah, I literally pick them randomly. So sometimes I will get more than one of the same colour in a video, and that is why. So this one has the standard BYS brush, which is, you know, not super wide, but it's also not super narrow. This is a pinky kind of red. If you tried to stamp with it, it would come out pink, not red, which is a problem with a lot of red polishes when you try to stamp with them. This is weird particles that I can see in the bottle. I think there must be pigment particles, but they're certainly not appearing on the nail. They just appear white in the bottle. But they're not glitters or anything. This is a completely... not quite a jelly. Not opaque, not translucent enough to be classed as a jelly. Certainly not a one coat red. But yeah, quite pretty. I will come back and do a second coat. Okay, so here we go with our second coat. This brings it fully opaque. There are some probably pigment particles. I've just got some on my nail. I can't get it back off again. I'm not going to fuss too much. It's ever so slightly, like from the angle I'm looking at on my ring finger, where I have quite a dark line underneath my free edge. I can still see that. It doesn't bother me. I'm just making a note. I can actually see it. So it's a nice enough red. These ones that are scented, the trick with scented ones, is they generally don't smell when they're wet. When they dry out, then the scent that they're supposed to be comes out a little bit more obviously, at least with these BYS ones. I don't know if you can see those weird white fleck things in there. A little strange. Could be scent particles or something. I have had it for quite a while, so yeah. I will insert a swatch picture. So this is the second red polish. This is L'Oreal's Court Red-Handed, in comparison to the BYS one. It's actually a little brighter. BYS is ever so slightly darker. They both have kind of like a pink undertone. They're kind of that pinky red, so a cooler red rather than a orangey red. Again, this is a polish I clearly bought on sale. The labels are cheapest chips in Australia. I bought a lot of these type of ones from cheapest chips. Like the entire one that had like Jennifer's Nude and Dootson's Nude and those ones. So this one is called Red-Handed. The brush for these polishes is quite a square brush. I actually quite like the flat brushes, even when my nails are short. This one is about the same consistency as the BYS one. And if you're wondering, I did not notice any cherry scent from the BYS one, so because it's so old, the scent might have dissipated. I know when I use the Revlon ones that are scented that I always smell them. It's always quite distinct, but that one, I couldn't smell anything. And I wasn't going to stick it right up against my nose. So that is the first coat. I will be back with a second. Alright, let's get on our second coat here. As you can see, it is still super shiny. These L'Oreal polishes are pretty underrated. I think they're pretty good. I can still ever so slightly see my nail line, but as I mentioned, I have quite a dark, particularly on this finger, on the ring finger, quite a dark line that demarcates it, at least to my eye. But this covers very nicely in two coats. It's a gorgeous red. And because it dries pretty shiny, you could get away with not wearing top coat if you weren't intending for it to last any more than a few days. So beautiful red from L'Oreal, caught red-handed, and I will insert a swatch picture. So the next polish we have is from Ulta 3. Ulta 3 is a brand that is apparently made in, comes out of France, I think, or Italy, or one of those places. But you pretty much seem to only be able to get it in Australia. It has no relationship whatsoever to Ulta stores. So, just in case you're wondering, this is obviously a topper. It's a clear base. It has black and white sparkles in it. It's called Stop the Press, which you already know because it's literally written on the front of the bottles. It's the thing with Ulta 3 polishes. Everything's written on the front of the bottle that you need to know. This looks really, really funny in the bottle, but it's probably fine. I have left on Caught Red-Handed from L'Oreal, which is what I normally do when I do toppers, which if you've seen any of these videos, you already know. I just don't usually talk about it. I'm only going to do the middle two fingers because that's my jam. This one I'm pretty sure is not very... Yeah. As you can see, it's not very dense. It's the word we want. It is one of those ones that you would probably, if you wanted a lot of them, you would need to do what I did with that one, which is put a lot on the nail, and the problem with that is that it takes a lot longer to dry unless you've got a really good quick dry top coat, or it makes the nails look really thick, which some people don't like. But it's good if you just wanted something really simple with just like a little bit of interest, and black and white looks pretty good on virtually any colour except obviously black and white, because then you wouldn't be able to see it, but you know what I mean. So like, this is like a really, I think, is a really cool manicure that, you know, it's not just plain red. Adds a bit of fun to plain red. But yeah. So that is Stop the Presses from Ulta 3. So Caught in the Act has stained my skin ever so slightly. Just makes me look like I've been attacking my cuticles. Which I kind of have, but not so that they'd be red. So, the next polish we have is a mini. This is Feel the Chemistry. This is from OPI's Infinite Shine range. I literally have maybe 5 Infinite Shine, and 4 of those are minis. And one of those 4 is a top coat, I think. I bought like a little mini set, because it was super duper cheap. It's a glorious colour. I just hate the fact that OPI don't put names on their minis at all, ever. So I have to make a label and put it on there so I know what the damn polish is, which I find incredibly frustrating. A lot of other brands managed to put a friggin' name on it. Why not you, OPI? Anyway, this Feel the Chemistry. Using mini bottles like this is a pain in the butt. I actually have a full-size bottle of this, however I'm sending that to a friend, so I don't want to open it. But this is a glorious purple base with what looks a lot like unicorn pea in it, which is that weird red sort of flash that you get. It really is gorgeous. I'm glad my nails are actually short to swatch this though, because these tiny little bottles with the tiny little brush, painting long nails like I had before, is like I literally have to paint half a nail and then paint the other half of my nail because the brushes and it just doesn't work. They're kind of annoying. But I really also like them. I have like two full boxes of mini nail polishes because I love them, but they're a pain in the ass. I'll be back with the second coat. Alright, here we go with the second coat. Job with that. I know it doesn't look like it to you guys probably, but yeah, it's because these brushes are, I mean I have baby hands and I struggle with these teeny tiny little brushes. I can't imagine what it would be like for someone with like big hands. Like, you almost need like a piece of pair of tweezers. And as you saw, I had to double dip for that one. Double dipping only ever acceptable when painting nails. Which means I have to do a little bit more finessing. In the full size, this will probably apply perfectly fine in two coats. It's just a little bit more challenging with these stupid little models. Although I love little bottles. I love this colour. I love this polish. I'm still not going to keep the full size of it. I have, even though I love it, because I have a ridiculously large collection and the person I'm intending to send it to does not have a ridiculously large collection. Although, if I send her all the polishes I'm planning to send her, I probably will double her nail polish collection. yeah, it is stunning. It is, really is a stunning polish. I will insert a swatch picture. Alright, our next polish is the first of two textured polishes that look really similar. There is not a lot of difference in them except for the sparkles that's in them. So this one is from Essence. This is Here's My Number. Now this one has holographic sparkles in it. I don't know if you can see them. But I can see all the colours of the rainbow, which means it has to be holographic because it's not like individual pieces are changing colour, not a whole rainbow of glitters in there. So this one is a grey base. And here we go. It has a wide flat brush, a lot like the ones in Sally Hansen polishes. Certain Sally Hansen polishes, I should say. Not all of them have it. It doesn't apply evenly onto the nail. It does this weird thing, which some polishes do, where they lay down heavy at the cuticle and then they just sit there. And they don't spread very well. But that's fine because we're going to have to put another coat on. And the second coat will have to be quite thick because it's a texture polish. So I will be back for a second coat. So you should be able to see the texture on those nails already. Basically what happens with a textured polish is that the base dries down and sort of shrinks slightly. And it leaves the particles, instead of being suspended in the polish, they kind of sit slightly proud of the polish, like they're still stuck in there, but they kind of rise above the polish slightly. And that is why you get that textured kind of look. It's the type of particles that they use. Now you tend to need a fairly thick second coat, because it's textured. Now this one, it looks like it probably wants a third coat, but I hate doing third coats on textured polishes. It's mainly on the ends of my nails, not at the back of my nail, which is kind of annoying. I really love a textured polish. I know not everybody does. That's fine. To each their own. A lot of people don't like it because of textural aspect of it. Like, they don't like rough surfaces or whatever. A lot of people say it makes the anxiety worse. For me, it is actually the opposite. I quite enjoy rubbing my finger over a rough surface. But it has to be a rough surface for a reason. So, like, if I rub my finger along the end of my nail and there's a rough spot, that will drive me bonkers until I do something about it. Or if I rub my finger over my skin and I can feel something sticking out of my skin that shouldn't be there, that will drive me bonkers. But a textured nail polish will not drive me bonkers because I enjoy the sensation of them when I'm rubbing my finger, because they're supposed to be textured. And that's the same with textured manicures. Like ones that have stuff sticking out of them, I quite like that. Like my thumb at the moment has this thing on the back here. It's actually a mermaid. She's stuck in acrylic. There are some other things there. I had to actually file down her tail and part of her arm, because they were actually dangerously sharp, and I kept on catching things on them. But I enjoy rubbing my finger over these, and it's all lumpy and bumpy, and I quite like that. But yeah, that's because it's meant to be like that. If it wasn't meant to be like that, that would annoy me. So yeah, I will insert a Swatch picture of here's my number, except it won't be my phone number, it'll be the nail polish. Here's my number left sparkles bloody everywhere. It's not difficult to remove at all. It just leaves little freaking bits of sparkle everywhere. So the last polish for this video is going to be this texture polish. This is from the Nicole Way OPI Gumdrops collection, which is like the Liquid Sands collection from normal OPI. This one is called Anise Treat. I hate licorice. This one does not have any holographic in it, so you can see it next to this one from Essence, the Here's My Number. It has holographic sparkles in it. This one does not. It's just kind of like a really dark grey with silver sparkles in it. And it's textured. So if you're not sure you like, well, if you don't like textured polish, there's an easy solution. It's called top coat. Look how wide this brush is. Wow. I don't remember their brushes being that wide. This is a big brush. Top coat. Put top coat on. You might need to use two coats, or you need to get, there's a product. It's basically a top coat, but it's called Glitter Feeder, I think it is. Can't remember what brand does it. I'll look it up and I'll put it on the screen. And that is, you know, like some glitter polishes are really textured because there's so much glitter in them. And then you put top coat on and they're still textured because they've got so much glitter in them. Textured polishes can be the same. You need to put top coat on them if you don't like the texture, which means all you get is like, you get all the sparkle and interest and everything, you just don't have texture. So, you know, just if you don't like texture, just paint over the top of it with top coat. It's like if you don't like matte nail polish, put shiny top coat on, it's no longer a matte nail polish. I will be back for a second coat. So we are back for a second coat. This one, I can tell already, is way more textured than the Essence one is. It literally looks like, you know, like 80, 60 or 80 grit nail polish, sandpaper. It has that real rough look to it. Now, this can be an issue. If you have really sensitive skin, you might want to be real careful because you will scratch yourself with it, particularly if you have a habit of putting hands on your eyes. Which you shouldn't be doing anyway, not that I can talk, but yeah, you can scratch yourself pretty bad. I know this because I've done it. And usually what I do if I have a polish that is like that, that is just too rough, and I do have a couple of them that the texture is just too much, I literally just put a coat of top coat on, and it retains some texture. Like the first coat will retain some texture. You need at least two coats with those to get rid of the texture. So that is one option, is to just put top coat on and it'll tone it down a little bit, make it a little bit easier to handle. But as I said, I really like textured polish. I will insert a swatch picture. So that's it for this swatch video. Let me know if you prefer it with me talking over the top of it instead of my weird notes at the end of each polish. Personally, I kind of prefer it this way because I can tell anecdotes and react on the fly, which you don't always get with the ones that I do the other way. And also the other ones, I have like 7 seconds of reading time to give all that information, which is a little difficult. Sometimes there are things I want to say that it's just too hard to say in that time frame. Let me know down below if you prefer it the other way. I can go back to doing it that way. It doesn't affect me that much. So that's it for this video. If you want to subscribe, click the button down the bottom. Leave me a thumbs up if you enjoy these kind of videos, and leave me a comment down below. I will like your comment, or I will answer any questions that you ask me, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.